This doesn't work. I'm gonna have to do some kind of like taming cage or something. You know, something I can like fly him into that can pin him in or something. Hey, what's up, y'all? Xerak here, going for that XP with a new episode of Ark Annunaki Genesis. I want to thank y'all for coming along with me, and if you like this video, help me get a little XP and level up by hitting that like button and subscribing if you haven't already. So today, I thought we'd hang out. I actually didn't have an episode come out today. This one that we're recording now will be coming out tomorrow, of course. But didn't have the chance to get an episode yesterday. Life happened. As can happen. But the good news is we're back and we're back in it today. So my thought for today is I wanted to go do a little taming. I'm not going to be able to take Rogue. We're going to take Ambien out. Because a couple of days ago, and I hope it is still there, but there was an Alpha Spino down by the river and I was kind of interested in maybe checking that out. So we're going to get Ambien, but you can see I got a bunch of stuff in my inventory because I've been gathering a little bit of resources today so we can make some more of these sedative narcotics. These are great. If you haven't gathered from watching already, what these do is they max out the torpor of whatever creature you remote use item on with it, but it also makes the food zero. So tames just happen practically instantly. Now it's not going to give you a better tame than say if you were taming with Prime normally. It just makes it a lot faster. We're going to have to do some other stuff to get into if we want to be doing better tames in that way, getting kibble together or something like that so we can get more perfect tames. But for now these are working for our purposes really well. I just save a bunch of that annoying sit around and wait time. Also made a couple of changes. I decided to ditch the crossbow because we got this legendary long neck rifle and I felt like using it. I also decided to carry a pistol instead of the sword. I'd put a scope on it. Pretty decent weapon there. So I'm carrying some of the ammunition for that. We do have the Annunaki poison darts in our long neck, but we're still going to try to do our taming with the bird here because it's just safer and easier. So let's go put away some of these things. You also might have saw I'm carrying some mayho berries with me just because I want to be opportunistic if we come across something cool. We're going to go ahead and throw our crystal, our mushrooms in here. And let's see here. I don't think I'll need more than 2 stacks of mayho. And I'm lazy, so I'm just going to throw that in there and those flowers in there. And I'm even going to take half these sedative narcotics and just leave 2 in there, but just to be safe. Oops, hold on a second. Yeah, we'll carry some narcotic with us just in case we need it. Let's get on Ambien here, and thankfully the fog has cleared up. Hopefully it doesn't start getting too dark on us here. Let's see what we see. He was a little ways down here. He was by the black sandy beach area that's just down here. So there's something going on here, some T-Rex business happening here. Always wonder if they do. Oh, look, we have a Prime Alpha Stego. Hit me. Did I just get nicked by a Bronto Tail? That is a Prime Alpha Stego. We've got a fire raptor down there. Let's see if I can see some levels on these guys. Obviously the Prime Alpha is going to be... That's my wing. There we go. He's 250. Like, he's actually fighting an Alpha Stego. That BA Utah Raptor. They are so dead, it's not even funny. I wouldn't even want to really take on that Stego right now. Those Prime Alphas are just tough. They're super hard to kill. But I don't see my Spino over here anymore. Oh, that's a bummer. Really do want to do some taming today, so we'll keep looking around for something worthy, worthwhile and worthy. I'd love to get an Alpha. I just was thinking an alpha would be cool, and then maybe give us something tough enough to take on, you know, BAs again, ever since we lost Mr. Bareface. Ursa Major was a mighty blow to our alpha killing ability. There's always the possibility of taking on a Drake, but I don't even know. Let's see. Is it made it? Oh, I think it's made in the Annunaki workbench, but there's a Drake trophy or something that you have to make in order to tame the Drakes. I mean, it's a possibility. I won't take it off the table, but I don't think that's going to be what we go for today. Besides, I'd probably go for a poison one if we get one. I'm going to keep flying around since Mr. Spino's not down here anymore. And we'll see what we come across, and I'll bring you guys back when I see something cool. Hey guys, welcome back. So I've been hunting for hours now, trying to find something good to tame. I wanted to show you, I got some cool things off a drop. I found a decent level alpha, 335, something like that, alpha saber. And I actually recorded going to tame the guy, and I'm on my Pteranodon, and I went and I hit it a couple of times with my Pteranodon and killed it. More than a couple of times, but it never tried to run away, and it started looking bloody, and so I slowed down and I tried not to drop it, but it just died. It never passed out. And I'm starting to get, I guess I'm kind of worried that my Pteranodon is killing things too quickly, but then on Brontos and stuff like that, it actually drops them before it gets there. So when we do find something, we'll have to be careful with it. I wanted to show you that Mind Wipe tonic, which I thought was awesome. And I also got a new pair of boots out of a drop, which I thought was pretty cool, but you know, I'm still on the hunt for something good. I also came, I even tried going to the winter biome to the north, which I don't have the gear to really hang out there long. But I did find a Rudolph, which is a reindeer, and that was pretty awesome. I knocked it out, and I couldn't open up its inventory to give it food. So I don't know if they're a passive tame or what. And so originally my thought had been, I'll bring you guys back, we'll come back to the base, and we'll look at doing, just gotta throw this in here for now, I really don't care to carry it all on me. Let me go get rid of my boots, and I need to dye the ones I'm wearing now. But I thought, you know, why not, let's go to the base, and it may be tough, or you can call it gutsy, or you can call it stupid, but I wanted to look into doing the, what we need to do to tame a Drake. Which of you guys has? Is it this one? There we go. I came back here so that we could take a look at taming a Drake. And you need an item in order to tame a Drake. Let's see, I need the mud coloring. There we go. You need an item to tame a Drake, and I'll show you guys in just a second here. Let's get these guys rocking and rolling. And we'll get that moved back over. Oh, and I'm out of, but to be honest, I have two chests full of bullets, so I'm just starting to drop them now. It's that bad. So this is the Annunaki workbench, and if we come here to consumables, meat, you get this Drake tribute, which I believe will instant tame a Drake. But you need a Drake trophy and a golden treat. Now, golden treats, my understanding is that you get from killing golden dodos, which I've never seen one. And I've been keeping an eye out for them. The Drake trophy, I have to assume you get from killing a dragon. In order to kill a dragon, we are going to need fast and deadly flyers. Right now, we've got Rogue here, who's pretty deadly, good bit of hit points, 10,000 melee damage, but we're not nearly fast enough. So I'm gonna have to go out with Rogue and get to probably do some leveling. So we can maybe consider that route. Now, of course, we'll keep our eyes open for something to tame in the meantime, but it's been a couple hours. I've looked around, I've been killing stuff, so stuff will respawn and be a better level, and I'm hoping we come across something decent. I'd like to. But we'll see how it goes. Like I said, for now, just gonna go kill stuff and try to get XP and hopefully some XP potions. And like I said, if we see something cool, I'll bring you guys back. Oh, that's a 535 scorpion, but that's not gonna help me. They've been fighting. Like, this Anki, this Raptor, and this Prime Alpha has just been fighting forever. You know, we can try. Let's see what happens. This could be good XP and entertaining. And I get to kill everything that aggroes me for some reason when it comes in on it. I don't like it when they go into the water. It's so annoying. Don't go into the water. You just want me to fall off my bird. Trust me, I can do that on my own by hitting the E button. Ooh, we got him bloody. Oh, we're gonna get some XP. I like it. Yeah. Look at this guy. He's wrecked. Oh, get some. I'm gonna wreck it. Yeah! Okay, so that's going for us. Yeah, some XP, hopefully some... I don't think they drop anything, but still. So that's our second Prime Alpha kill. Not too bad. Check this out, guys. We're gonna have a series of Prime Alpha kills on us, maybe. I'm up near the cold biome, which, as you can see, is pretty awesome looking. I'm guessing thanks to my little bit of fortitude I've pumped, I'm not ice cubed right now, but look at this Prime Alpha. I'm assuming it's Prime Alpha. I haven't even looked at it with the spyglass yet, but Prime Alpha Woolly Rhino, yeah. God, they are so cool looking. Let's see if we can get in some trouble here. Why isn't he attacking? There we go. I stay low with them because after some of the fights that I was doing, I'm afraid they regenerate if you get too high up in the air. Like, they just clip out of combat. But look, we're taking him out too. Oh yeah. Prime Alpha number 3. If you take my kill, T-Rex, I'm gonna murder you. There we go. That's where it's at. Nice. So that's our third Prime Alpha kill. Let's thin the wolf pack a little bit. Let's see. We need to get somewhere to land for just a second so we can do a little quick level up action. I wanted to bring you guys back just to check that out. And I'm going to keep hunting for stuff. If I come across any other interesting dinos to kill, I'll bring you guys back. But hopefully we'll get lucky and find something to tame. Otherwise, maybe we'll get enough levels that we can keep up with a dragon. Hey guys, welcome back. I told you I'd bring you back if I found something else interesting. And I am a man of my word. So I'm going to show you something that I find at least very interesting after we eat a couple more faces over here. Because can't let that delicious XP go to waste. So let's check out what we got on speed so far. Oh, and I got a new pistol, by the way, which is awesome. I got it, I'm pretty sure, off of that rhino I just killed. But I was flying over here, and I noticed that guy. Check him out. Oh my gosh. First off, I want to tame him. I want to tame him so bad. but I'm gonna guess he's like the brood mother and insanely difficult to kill or to knock out. But I want to see if we can actually hurt him with our super bird here. Looks like he's bloody. He's definitely doing more damage to us than anything else has so far. Oh, did you see? I didn't see what that level said. Did y'all see that? 365. Holy crud. Ah, this guy's already got us down to half. I don't see any... I think what I'm seeing is blood is what's already on him as part of a graphic. Yeah, we're not gonna mess with that anymore. But he is cool looking, and I just wanted to show him to y'all because... Man, doesn't he look awesome. Oh, so cool. Definitely want to get one of those eventually. But for now, we'll just content ourselves with killing more T-Rexes and getting levels. And staying away from him because he apparently doesn't... Oh, there's another one. Look at that. Look at that. And we're maxed. We've maxed out our level. We're movement speed 201.2%. I was hoping to get to 205 and then maybe put a little bit more into health, but this is what it's going to be. So whether we can do it or not, this is going to be the best opportunity, the best shot that we have. So I was thinking to finish things up today, what we would do is kill a drake. And I'm hoping that we can. I have killed one before, but every time I've done it in the past... I've done it with my pteranodon, my pteranodon rather, because my pteranodon can do the little squirrely attack. I'm a little hesitant about this guy, though he does seem to be rather preoccupied with whatever he's trying to get at back here. So if I can keep darting in and out and hitting him. And I said, and hitting him. Ah, we got him. And we ate him instantly. Did we get anything? Didn't think it dropped off them. I have actually killed one and searched the body before as well. So, I believe there is a drake. A dragon. Over this way. Over yonder. Let's... give it a quick fly. And you can see that we are moving much faster now, which is very nice. I'm liking it. I just went through and killed pretty much every Paraceratherium, Brontosaurus, Diplo, whatever, Saurus, Diplodocus. Killed a bunch of dips. I swear there was a guy. You're not one of like those special ones, are you? Nope. Oh, holy crap. That was a BA level 600. Not sure what I would have done with you, but you would have been cool to have. Alright, so there he is. Is that another Primo? Well, I don't want to kill another one with this guy, because they're really good XP, and he doesn't need any more. Well, remember, there's a Prime Alpha Kitty over there. Alright. See, he takes off instantly. And the problem is lining it up for a hit. I have to like kind of pull up at the last second because he likes to attack on top. There we go. So if we keep... There's another hit. See, the problem is not the damage he deals, it's not how much damage I deal, it's being able to hit him in the first place. Come on. Yeah. Ah! Fire missiles! Come on. Where's my machine guns? I just hope he's not healing every time he disengages. teeth broken? Come on, use them. This doesn't work. I'm gonna have to do some kind of, like, taming cage or something. You know, something I can, like, fly him into that can pin him in or something. I haven't hit him in so long, I'm sure he's not even damaged anymore. Ooh, there's two. Preemptive with my attack here. I'm hitting it when I got him on target, and I need to lead it a little bit and hope I get him. There's a bit of a charge-up time before it considers the attack to be initiated. Ah. I wonder if it's easier to do first person. Oh, maybe. There's a hit. Is that what I think it is? Yep, that's exactly what I thought it was. I'm glad there's no fog right now to wash everything out. Can't play in that point of view on mount. It's just the lack of peripherals just throws me off. There's a Rudolph. You killed Rudolph. How are we supposed to get Christmas presents this year, huh? I'd say you get nothing but coal in your stocking, but as a fire breather, that's probably something you're a fan of. I'm on fire, but I'm cold. Hey guys, welcome back. So, the fight with the dragon, I mean, it didn't go bad in so much as that I was getting too hurt or anything like that. I mean, he was doing damage to us. Yeah, but I mean, and it's not insignificant, but it's nothing like the giant Megapithecus or any of those crazy guys. So it's survivable for sure. But the problem is I'm not landing enough hits on him to be able to do damage to him to bring him down. And that's purely just a factor of movement. You know, he spins around in circles, and it's not necessarily so fast, but it's such weird angles and that he comes down to that the hits I get on him are intermittent, and I'm pretty sure that he's healing him faster than I'm hurting him. And so we just need to be able to apply damage directly to him consistently. And so my thinking is that we'll build a box. We'll build a kill box, something that we can lure him into, and that we can even be inside of with him. I'm not worried about that part of it, like I said, for this fight, but so that he doesn't have anywhere to go, so that we're just laying the damage down on him. So what I've been doing is I've gathered a bunch of metal, a bunch more cementing paste, and even started making up some polymer and everything, just so I can make a couple of behemoth gates. And my idea is to use this little ravine, and I'll show you guys where we're at. Base is literally right over there. We'll use the ravine here to kind of make a kill box with a couple of behemoth gates on either end. We'll do some columns so that we can do some roofs going across. We'll make a bit of a box. And I'm literally thinking a row of columns going this way with some foundations down here so that the ceilings will have support. And that's it. We'll just use this natural wall on one side and the columns on the other side. Hopefully we can space them in such a way that that he can't get out, but more important is the roof, because even if he can turn a little in here, he can't get away from us, and it's not going to be as much of a dodgy kind of pain in the butt battle as it's been. Now, I had to do metal because when I was fighting him earlier, I decided to try to lure him over here with the same thought, seeing if I could maybe get him somewhat stuck in here so I could just chew on his face a bit, you know, even if it was just his head or something stuck inside, right? But he destroyed the stone gate that was on here, so obviously he can destroy stone. So some of this building's still gonna have to be stone, but I had to sacrifice a bunch of metal and spend a bunch of time gathering stuff so that we could do some of this out of metal. So I do have some more stuff on me. I've made some pillars. I got a couple of door frames, I think, just so it easy run in, run out without having to open the big door. You know, another behemoth gateway and gate, and then a bunch of stone foundations and a couple of metal foundations. I'm going to do the metal foundations with the metal pillars sticking out of them. So that way, even if he destroys the stone stuff, we don't lose all the super expensive resources that went into making the metal stuff. But I'm going to start building this. And then what I would like to do next time is get him trapped in here. You know, I don't think Gideon's going to be joining us next time either. So it's just going to be us versus the dragon next time. So we're going to give that a shot and see what we can do. But for now, I'm going to do a little bit of building on this, and maybe we'll finish it up at the beginning of next episode. But for that, that's going to be it for today. So thank you again for coming to hang out with me. And as always, if you guys have any comments or questions, make sure to leave them down below. And if you want to help me get a little XP and level up, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe. I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.